What's up, gamers?
Howdy, howdy.
We're doing a casual boots race. On the ladder. That means we have to do escape. We start with boots. We start with a sword. I'm feeling a little tired today. I don't know why. Probably because I got up too early today or something. Or didn't get enough coffee. But hopefully the seed will be generous. Unlike all of my recent seeds, which have all been terrible. But fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Yeah, I hope everyone's doing alright. I had a good time on comms earlier. Very exciting race. It's always good when a race comes down to a Ganon fight. At least as a commentator. Makes things interesting. Thanks for the sip. I know it's not coffee, but at least I can kill all the rats for bombs, it's true. Not that I care too much about bombs this time around. Shovel! Ah! Clearly the answer is to dig up some bombs right outside of escape. Easy every time. Yeah, it's funny because the last four commentary sessions I've had, I've commentated with Tracy and with JP, so. And I wasn't even originally going to commentate today, but so I think Captain was in that slot, but I think he got called into work or something. Seen any with Tracy? I just did commentary with Tracy less than an hour ago. Yeah, it's La Milana music. Yo, what's up, Daft? That's fair. La Milana is a tough game to play. If you've never played it before, but the music is banging. It's a good enough reason alone. I think the original, or the La Mulana remake, is on sale on Steam right now for $5. Oh, you have it already. All right, well. Never mind. Good old glove. Glove in the back of escape. Made almost no progress after 4 hours? What the heck were you doing? I kind of want more bombs, but... I'll be fine. Should go south route and check shovel. I mean, that is kind of how that game plays out. You finally find, like, some bit of progression, and it gives you, like, none. And you're like, okay, well, I guess that wasn't the big thing I was supposed to go do. Bum, 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 bum. Alright, change of plans. I want dollars, so I'm gonna get some. Do this instead. Half magic. That's good info. All right, well, hopefully a book doesn't show up right away. I was thinking about going down to South Shore, but I'd rather hold off until I have enough money for Zora so I can do that all in one go. Magic. Excuse me! Okay. For now, it would kind of suck if, like, Mini Motor Cave had a bottle or a flute or something. Because I was so close to checking that, just so, you know, in case I find a bottle or flute over there. To make this visit a little bit more efficient. But Master Sword is good. My money. Okay. Just a hammer away, or another glove. Probably go see what's at Lumberjack then. Guess we'll turn this just entire route up to probably dip in the mountain. Yeah, we can't get to the Dark World now via Aga. But then just, what, go to Catfish, go to Pod? I don't know about that. Interesting. A bow at Lumberjack. Boy, that's not something you see every day. Now, if only the progressive bows didn't exist. I might just go ahead and get that. First bottle. I guess I have to get it. I haven't even seen what my dungeons are in the Light World yet. Okay. So we definitely need a bow for this seed. Scenario to be in. Okay, well, that kind of eliminates the Houlihan usefulness, but I don't know. So, if we do all the Zora stuff and don't find anything, then we either... I think we just go ahead and get the bow. Even if another bow shows up, I mean, elsewhere in the game, then, you know, we get silvers. And we can go clear a crystal eastern. It'd be a lot easier to make that decision if the bows were not progressive, but they are. Another 300. Okay, it's nice, doesn't progress anything, but still nice to have. Yeah, let's just go ahead and go for the Aga play. I think that's an okay play to make. Then after that, we can go activate Flute, check Sick Kid, Flute back over, do Eastern into Saha, and then we still don't find any Glover Hammer, then. Somebody already forfeit? What the heck? Bummer. Yeah, we can go get our bow, activate flute, check Sick Kid, and go beat Eastern Saha. And then probably eventually lead into the hammerless pod dive. Oh, that would have been a key dash. I don't know why I stopped. Wow. Nice block. Thanks for the good luck, Mizu. Combos. No, let's just go ahead and get Catfish out of the way. It's probably not the right answer, but... Of course, Pendant Thieves and 5 and 6 are Pod and Meyer. Alright. Well, there's my glove. Good call, me. Well done. It just kind of depends on where the hammer is. And I guess where the other bow is. But... we can do quite a bit now. Hmm. I guess we'll go ahead and head to the Dark World, and I mean, I should just immediately go back to Eastern. But we can go beat Skull Woods and route down to, like, Hype Cave or something, maybe. Nah. We should stick to the plan. It's not like doing Eastern is going to be slow or anything. Yeah, that's the thing is if... I mean, if Hammer's like in Pod or like Eastern or something, that'd be a game changer for me. Getting the mitts off of Catfish. Oh, boy. Maybe. Another late Hammer Seed. Great. My favorite. Do, do, do. Well, I can get that half magic now. No. Yeah, that does not sound fun. Sorry, Misu. Hopefully it goes... Hopefully it goes well, obviously. Good luck to ya! Anonymous! Thanks for the gift, Rational Lies. Appreciate that very much. Hey, Jack. How's Pokemon treating you? You taking good care of that Vulpix? I should do another Llamalana rando sometime. It's been a hot minute. Switch is charging while you eat. What are you snacking on? At this point, I would love if the Hammer's chilling right here, maybe. Actually, I don't know. It would depend on where the bow is, I guess. Nah, not Pokemon Snap. Jack picked up Pokemon Sword, was it? Not Shield. The one with the sword dog in it, and not the shield dog. The scary thing about this seed now is Thieves Town, probably. Whoa! Wow! Anonymous! What are you doing? Thank you so much for the 5-pack. We got Enola Clay, Andrew SF, Shinmaru, 007, Smitty Kitty, and Captain Nalate. Captain Annihilate, there we go. Nailed it. There's so much sound going on right now. Second time I've done that. Well, thank you very much. Appreciate that. You can definitely get shield at some point. Do you need both? Thank you. 96 subs in this channel. Crazy. Okay, well, here we go again. We gotta look for a hammer. I'm gonna quickly go to desert, I think. I'm gonna do Desert Mire real quick. Partially because I want that half magic. Why does this keep happening? Why do I keep on getting these seeds like this? Nothing on Armos. Maybe there's something in Pod? I thought it was too. But. And yeah, when you have two runners both doing a Ganon phase 4, it's impossible to keep track of both of them, so you're literally just kind of. You just focus on one and you're just waiting for one of them to explode, so. I actually didn't even know. Or even notice how. I think I was just watching Korai because they were in the lead. So I didn't even know how the other guy was doing. But yeah. Close second race. Hammer? And of course, Landmolus has an item. I think it's still early enough that I can probably do that without feeling too bad. It does feel like a bit of a strange play altogether, though. I've had, out of like my last four commentaries I've done, I think I've had two of them that the lead changed in the Ganon fight, so. That's always interesting. So, hammer could be in Pod, it could be in Ice, it could be in West Dark World. There's so many places it could be. Time to last location that. This play feels bad, but it feels better now than if I was like an hour in doing this. Well, hopefully I'm done within an hour.
Oh.
That looked about right. I'm gonna check Myra Shed, then we can check Pedestal. Maybe there's something on the pedestal that I need. Okay, I don't really want you to be Bombos, because I don't want to feel obligated to dip Myra looking for the hammer. Okay. Tis Aether. Dude, I don't even have the mirror yet. Come on. Pedestal could be a lot of things, depending on how the layout stuff is. But we would still probably... need the mirror. Or a hookshot hammer. Cool. Alright. Well, desert was pointless. Perfect. Shaved prime rib with broccoli, mushrooms, and cheese? That sounds really tasty. I want it. Gimme. If I had a mirror, I'd do back to front, but since I don't, I'll do front to back. But yeah, I mean, at this point, like, until my hammer shows up, everything sucks. Thank you. Alright! Nothing sucks anymore. Wonderful. Alright, so what do we need to beat this stupid game? You know what? I'll save Skullwoods for later. I don't need to beat it right now. It's not even a Pyramid Fairy Crystal. I need to find the mirror at some point, so we can always go back, kill Moth, mirror, and then food away. So we can go and finish Pod. What sucks is having Fire Rod, getting that hammer would have been, like, ridiculously easy to do. That does mean that this is 100% an Agus Seed, though, so that's good. Regardless of whether that bow at Lumberjack is actually... regardless of wherever the other bow is... So yeah, I guess we'll go... we'll route down... I'll probably go do Pod next. Because I want to maybe hold off on doing Ice Palace until I find Samaria. Okay, Alright, so I'm feeling good as long as, you know, my opponent dipped pod before doing catfish, which I feel like would be pretty common to do. Though probably not. Just because, you know, if hammer's in pod, you want that bow. That's that lumberjack. Yo, take it easy, Jesse. Hope you feel better. So we need Ice Rock, Samaria, Aether, Hookshot, Mirror, and maybe another medallion. I'm gonna skip the Smith Chain for now. Hookshot next, maybe, please? I guess? I don't know. Hookshot, Samaria, one of the two. Cool. Thank you. Alright. Okay. Uh-huh. Jeez. Well, I guess I'm going straight to Ice Palace then. Well, this is interesting. Now I just want to get Hookshot before Mirror. Mirror Go Mode would be fine. I mean, the only thing I'm worried about now is Thieves Town. Even the front of Thieves Town, because I skipped it. But we're going to do all of Ice. We'll go do all of Pod. And then, you know, if Aether shows up, we'll go do all of Mire. I guess the one thing I'm scared about is if the Mirror shows up. Because then, you know, there's the possible Hookless Swamp. I think I'll go ahead and hit the switch anyway. Just because that first chest was an item. Music is from Lamalana 1 and 2 remakes. Lamalana 1 remake and Lamalana 2 is good. See, there's two items already. Good thing I hit the switch. Smart, smart, smart. So nothing really, but that does put Spike Cave in logic. So I might go check that next before going to pod. I guess the only downside would be is if I find the mirror. I guess that doesn't matter. Yeah, if I didn't hit the switch there, I would have had to have looked around for the big key. I would have lost time. Actually, no, I did check what was bumper ledge. It was nothing. So yeah, I definitely want to go do Spike Cave next. No, not that. He was supposed to take my shield. This way, if this is nothing, I can reset, get my magic back, and then we'll head over to Pod. Shot. Dang. All right, to Palace of Darkness. So once again, the big thing that's worrying me is probably Thieves Town. Thieves Town or Smith Chain. If we clear Pod, don't find anything, then I mean that's pretty much all I have left. Ether and Pod to get Hookshot in Mire off of Vidi. To get Mirror for Go Mode on East Death Mountain. That's all I want. Piece of cake. If I can get the big key in the front, then I can just route this a little bit better. Or not. This is Llama Llama music. Don't do it. See, that's annoying. Because now the vanilla big chest could be... Boy, I don't know how to do this one anymore. I guess this is fine as long as the big key isn't vanilla. So, I mean, there's a chance it could be five keys in the front. That's possible, too. Okay, one item. Or two item. Gosh, I should just go kill Helma. Because otherwise I have to either route this stupid or Death Warp. And Death Warp being... I mean, it's not too bad because of the Kadongos, but with Red Mail... I guess it does a heart of damage regardless of mail. Nice hammer jump. Genius. Oh yeah, I have two fairies in bottles, so I'm glad I didn't try in Death Warp. Okay. That's okay. Here's our hookshot. That also does mean that Vanilla Big Key Chest is either going to have an item or the map. So we'll have to go back in and get that after this. If Helma gives us the map. Yeah. Not the best pod routing, but it'll work. And I'm going to... I mean, I guess I'm going to continue to put off Smith Chain and Thieves Town. Good chance we're gonna go full clear all of T-Rock coming up. And I might just immediately go for T-Rock, not even check like Paradox Cave. Oh yeah, we still need Aether as well. Well, here's the funny thing. So, if someone went into pod and knocked Catfish after Agga, they would have got the hookshot, which would allow them to hookshot across the broken bridge, thus skipping out on the mitts at Catfish. Chances of my opponent doing that are pretty slim, but you never know. Don't be a map, please. Thank you. To the mountain! Ugh. So obviously, worst case scenario is the mirror is in Hera or on Aether Tablet. It would also be obviously a time loss if we go up the mountain. Go straight to T-Rock, and it's also Aether. But... because I don't want to... I don't want to go to Tower of Hera. I don't mind full clearing T-Rock, because it's not that big of a deal. That's why I'm more inclined to just go ahead and dive into the Dark World. I'll go ahead and do Paradox, though. It's right here. And if my Gomo's in here, then that'd be huge. So yeah, we're just banking on Pendant Thieves or Smith having nothing. Said don't. 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 Come on, Bombos. Alright, well, that's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and just do it. Ooh. I mean, the only risky thing is if Mimikave has Aether. I guess we'll check this first. Mm-hmm. So we just need Mirror and Aether for Gomug. That's it. Fairy and a mushroom. Okay. The scary thing is, after this, all we'll have left is Pendant Dungeons and Overworld if we don't find Aether Mirror. I'll probably go check Mushroom first. Then Powder. We have, what, four items in Thieves, plus Smith and Purple Chest. We have two items in Hera, plus Green Pendant, plus Aether Tablet, plus Spiral Cave. And then we have Mushroom and Bat. Fine. I'll get the other ones. Asshole. Alright. If there's anything I would want, I'd want the classic mirror on Laser Bridge to mirror back to Mimic Cave for Aether. That's the dream. Two hearts in here. Useless cape. Okay, two more items in this dungeon. Two more chances for that mirror or Aether. Another three heart containers and a cape? You stupid game. Alright, the dream, right here. Wanted Aether first, but this is fine. Another heart container. Dang it. Now I gotta go through all this again. Okay, well, that opens up a lot of stuff. The question becomes, do I just go straight to Swamp? Or do I run around the world? Checking mirror spots. Or do I stay up on the mountain and, like, finish Hera? It could have been so many different things, Locke. It didn't have to be another heart container. Nah, what's gonna happen? Stupid Anti-Fairy. I should stick to my guns and go finish Thieves Town anyway. Take that, Tiamat! We know Pyramid Fairy's dead. Joy. So we got what? Gravel Edge, K45, Bombos Tablet, Olive Swamp, Olive Thieves, Smith. All of Hera, Spiral Cave. I'm checking Bombo's tablet. That's it. And I'm leaving. I'll check one item in Hera. So long. Hope it's not in there. No more. No more heart containers. No 20 dream. Both tablets, so the book was useless, aside from getting half magic. There's nothing on that, on any of that. Alright, before I dip in here though, I'm gonna go check my fetch quests.
We meet again.
Thank you for the 17. Appreciate that. Hope you're having a good one. Compass. Really? Bone! Mm-hmm. I think after Swamp, I either run up and do Smith Chain, or I check, like, I don't know, Checkerboard Cave? If it's in Hera, I'm screwed, because I'm not going back there anytime soon. Oh, no. I'm skipping left side for now. I miss. That's impressive. Yeah, that sucked butt. I think I go back and check big chest. If it's an item, I leave. If it's a map, I do left side, I guess. I mean, worst case scenario is my opponent missed mitts on catfish for a bit, and like, worst case scenario, I think, would be if Aether is like front of thieves. That would suck. But it's not. It's in the big chest here. Right. So we only did a little extra. I mean, after getting the mirror, we mirrored out to check Mimic Cave, which I feel like my opponent would do that too, in this case. And then we checked Aether Tablet, which, who knows, my opponent might have done Aether Tablet, Spiral Cave, or Tower of Hera before actually going into the Dark World and just clearing that area. It's honestly hard to feel bad in this seed. I feel like I've played this one pretty damn well. Like, aside from, all things considered, like, my slowest checks I've done would have been anything between getting the mirror and going to Swamp. Which isn't too much. And hell, my opponent could have dipped pod looking for hammer. You never know. For some reason, hour 15 go mode feels late. But this was also an Aghanim seed, so... you Did you get down here? What are you doing? Big dummy. And yeah, if my opponent did, that's the crazy thing, is if my opponent did pod first into After Dark World, you know, they would have gotten the hook shot. They might have skipped Catfish to do West Dark World. That's a possibility too. There's a lot of things that could happen. Now that you did it, I have a question. I have to question you, yeah? Why'd I bail on Moth the first time I was there? Because I wanted to, I didn't want to have to save and quit or backtrack out of the back of Skull. And I only had a Master Sword, so I would have been fine, but I knew I needed a mirror to beat the game. So I figured I could wait until I had the mirror, and then I can just mirror out after Moth and then flute away. Now, an argument could be made whether that was actually faster or not. Sick. So none of the pendant dungeons were required. Oh yeah, if there was anything that I'd feel behind about, it'd be killing Lanmolas. But that was also, like, before I actually found the hammer, so until you find the hammer, there's really no wrong choices in routing. Though Skullwoods would have been the really easy play, because it was a crystal dungeon and you had Fire Rod already, like, really early. Alright, that's all 7 crystals and 1 pendant. Let's head to Ganon's Tower to lose more time. Someone like to ask Willard Games where he thinks is the big key's gonna be. What the hell, dude? This is what I get for making you a permanent Twitch partner or Twitch sub to my channel. I see how it is. I am glad that I didn't. I was considering maybe checking Magic Bat before Dipping Swamp as well, since it's just a quick flute away, but I'm glad I didn't. That would have been a bit of time loss. Okay, time to stick to my gut. That big key is never right side. Hell Temple. Stupid hitbox. See? It's never right side. That is for dorks. Dang it! That cuts deep. Wheeler Games is getting close to being correct. Thank you. 20. Suck it. Oh, jeez. That sure was a fun trip through GT. That was very well done. Good job, me. Really? I've been hitting, like, all the wrong diagonals lately. It's driving me nuts. Good job, Fire Shield. You're really doing your job. Yeah, I think all things considered, like, the two things that cost me the most time in the seed were desert, and then all my extra checks between getting the mirror in T-Rock, or completing T-Rock and going to Swamp. Sorry, 15 people done? Crazy. Thank you. Neat. That was a good fight. Alright, let's see how I did. I lost by 7 seconds. Cool!